Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a little while. I haven't been very on top of that YouTube game. I don't really have YouTube game, but I'm working on it. So today I wanted to get this tutorial up because I thought it would be a great winter accessory, or maybe you want to make it as a gift for people this holiday season. I mean, I would love to receive this fuzzy scarf, neck warmer, snood. You can call it whatever you want, but basically it's super warm, super cozy. As you can see, I use this short haired like faux fur material. It's actually left over from a previous tutorial I did, which is my DIY tidy coat, and I'll leave a link down below so you can go click on that if you want to learn how to make. And it's also a great gift to give to your friends and family, and I'm sure they would all love it. So basically it's just a single tube, like so. So you just wear it like this, like a neck warmer. And this is super duper cozy. It's kind of like looser, so it doesn't matter what shape your head is, or like if you have an updo or a hat, it'll still fit over it. And I kind of like this better than an actual scarf at the moment right now, because it's less bulky. Usually scarf I have to like wrap around twice, and then it creates a lot of like volume at the front of my jacket, and I find it's a little bit annoying. So this is kind of like an alternative for a scarf, and it's been trending quite a bit. Like I saw some of these at Uniqlo when I was in Japan, and then I saw Club Monaco was selling them as well, so I thought why not DIY it, because it's so easy and super cheap to make as well. So if you want to learn how to make this super cuddly faux fur scarf, keep on watching. Okay, so for this tutorial, you'll just need some faux fur of any color that you want, some matching thread, and a sewing machine. You can also do this without a sewing machine. May want to have some pins so you can help pin things together, and it makes it easier to align things, and that's about it. First things first, you're just going to cut out a rectangle that is 31 inches by 25 inches. You will be pinning the fur sides together, so then you will be seeing the back side, and you want to pin along the long edge of the rectangle, and you will be sewing a straight stitch down this line.
Thank you.
So what you'll want to do after you've sewn that long edge along the length of the rectangle is to half flip the tube in half so that the fur sides are still touching together and that you're still seeing the back side of the fur, and you want the ends to meet. Sewing this last edge, be sure to leave about 2 to 3 inches of unsewn space, and this is going to be the area where you are flipping the whole neck warmer inside out, and then you will be hand stitching that part at the very end. After you've sewn that last edge, leaving that 2 to 3 inch gap, you're going to take that opening and flip your whole thing inside out or right side out so that the fur is on the outside, and you will just take a needle and thread and then close up the opening. And I kind of just take a little bit from each side and I just alternate from side to side, taking little bits along this line, and then it kind of just sews itself together, so it's almost like a zigzag pattern just to close it up. I don't think it has to be perfect because I can't really see what I'm doing sewing through fur, and B, as long as there's no hole when the person's using it, I think it's pretty successful. So just kind of like run my finger along, because sometimes like the gap between stitches is too far and I'll just have to go back and add an extra stitch, but in general you can't even tell where it was. All closed up, and you can just zhuzh up the fabric a bit so that it's not as obvious that this is where the seam is, but you can't even tell. It just looks like any other part of the neck warmer. So I'm just gonna tie it off with a knot, and that's basically it. Thank you. So this is the final result. It's an oversized neck warmer, which is super duper fuzzy. Like, look at this. It's so soft. But yeah, let me know if you recreate it using the hashtag Deconstrut, and I'd love to see your recreations. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.